Baroque taxidermy is a genre of pop surrealist art that utilizes conventional taxidermy-related materials in an unconventional manner. Taxidermy for a long time really had a stigma attached to it where it was like wearing a fur coat. You're hurting animals, you're exploiting animals. The animals I work with die of natural causes or are byproducts of the livestock industry. People don't think about their animal consumption. When I say consumption, not even what you eat. They don't think about the clothing they wear, the products they use. But you know, when you're looking at taxidermy, it has eyes. It forces you to think about it. The Goth Griffin, which is a combination of a crow and a black cat, was the piece that was on the front page of the New York Times art section in 2004, and that was the catalyst for the interest in the genre. When people came to be part of our group and wanted to kind of work under that umbrella of rogue taxidermy, they had to pledge that they wouldn't harm animals to make the work. So that kind of rebranded taxidermy, like all of a sudden it wasn't about killing an animal. It has a recycling aspect to it. Capricorn is constructed out of a stillborn lamb, a carp, and grouse wings, and then the antlers on that are from a vintage roe deer trophy plaque. A lot of people, when I first started doing this, didn't think that what I was doing was acceptable whatsoever. Not ethical, not moral. I never understood why I would get just like lambasted, attacked, just like horrible hate mail, whereas men that were doing it, no hate mail. Taxidermy is really rapidly losing that good old boys club feeling that it had for so many years. Not to say that there never were awesome female taxidermists before, but now we've got women that are like at the forefront of what's been popularizing taxidermy.